Hey guys, we got a special treat. Jeff and I came to New York City on the way back from India. So we are in Central Park. And Central Park, you may not know this, but most urban parks are full of medicine, just chock full. And Central Park is kind of unique because somebody a really long time ago, or a bunch of somebodies, put together this idea of having this 50 like block park right in the middle of just city. So in a minute we'll show you all the skyscrapers all around us, but right now you can see we're really in an urban environment. People are ice skating behind me and saw a couple kids take a couple spills, so that's always hard. But what we want to talk about, I get distracted, is this white pine that's right behind me. Excuse me. There's a number of pines around in Central Park, and they all look really good. You know, we're having a lot of problems with pine in the West, and also on the East Coast with the pine beetle, and I think a blight that's taking it too. But anyway, the ones in Central Park here are really vibrant. They look good. The way that we identify pine, now pine is different from, you know, conifer trees. Conifer, a lot of people use those words independent or interchangeably, and that's not correct. A pine actually has needles. See the needles? Whereas a conifer, like a cedar tree or a spruce tree or a fir tree, doesn't have needles. These are needles. And the way that botanists identify the different types of pine is by how many needles are in a cluster. So here we've got, let me see, I haven't counted these yet, and I am not prepared, but as usual. But let's see, we've got 3, 4, 5. Okay, so this is five of these needles in a cluster. So when you look up a botany book and you try to figure out what kind of pine we're looking at here, that's how we can tell. So this is a white pine. And what do we use pine for medicinally? Many of the trees are used, I think of them as, what are they really good at protecting themselves? They're really good at protecting their skin, so they're really good skin medicine. They're also really good lung medicine, so skin and lung. Well, the skin and lung embryologically isn't that different from each other. And you always think, well, how could that be? Lung is this organ inside, skin is this tissue on the outside. And they're both ectodermal type tissues, so they're both lung and skin are derived from similar fetal embryology. So, ooh, we have some police officers coming on motorcycles. That should be interesting. So anyway, how do we make medicine from this beautiful tree? And as far as I know, you can use pine year-round. Most people like to use pine in the spring. A lot of these trees also are very nutritional, high in vitamin C. You can take like spruce tip tea, you can take pine tip tea in the spring when the energy's into the needles. My grandmother, she grew up in Maine, and they used to chew the pine sap instead of chewing gum. I don't think it tasted as good, but she lived on a maple syrup farm, so she was able to kind of make things taste good with maple syrup. But pine sap has long been used as an external wound medicine and also internally to help strengthen the lungs. You could use it as a steam. You could cut a branch off and cut the little needles up, put hot water over it, put a towel around a bowl and breathe that in so you could get those essential oils into the lung as an antibiotic, antimicrobial. And also opening up the airways, there would be a physical kind of opening to the bronchioles with this medicine. And so you can use the resin, you can use the tea, like we just talked about, using cutting up the needles, and you can also use the bark. And some people would combine the bark and the needles and use that as medicine. So it's really cool. There's all this other medicine around. I'll just quickly go into it. We've got also some red oak on the ground. You may know that white oak is also very rare. But here we have red oak. And I'm just looking at the leaves. Of course, the trees are mammoth in Central Park for oak. And oak's a big medicine. We've talked about that one before. We also have, you know, the typical city type herbs. We have dandelion. We have a burdock, or a dock of some sort, on the other side. And what? Did I mention anything else, Jeff? There's a number of. They have smilax here in the park, which is also a medicinal, used for a lot of different immune issues. The root is. Anyway, and we're here in Central Park. You know, it's just amazing that you have all these medicines right here. But I really wanted to thank the White Pine for standing strong in this city. And also, just a quick little thought. After 9/11, it was said that the grief attacked people's lungs. So in Chinese medicine, grief is something that attacks the lung. You know, we have different emotions associated with different organ systems. And even if White Pine just stood by us, I think energetically, it would help to absorb some of that grief. So White Pine's a strong medicine, both spiritually, emotionally, and also for our organs, our lungs, our skin. So anyway, I'm just really thankful, even here in the park. So we'll see you guys next month. Thanks so much. Bye.